Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. There's been a lot of questions about our Duraflex joints, so we put together this video to help you better understand what the Duraflex is and how it works. On our control arms, we use Duraflex joints at both ends, which gives an unprecedented ride quality and suspension flex. But what is the Duraflex? Let's take a look inside. Disassembly is easy, requiring no special tools. The first step is to remove one of the retainer clips, sometimes called a C-clip. Next, use a screwdriver to remove the support washer. The easiest way to pop out the insert, or what we call the Duraflex bushing, is to grab a half-inch bolt and nut, thread the two together, and insert it into the sleeve of the Duraflex bushing. Using a common hammer, just give it a pop, releasing the Duraflex bushing and backside support washer. The backside retaining clip can remain in place. There is no need to remove it at this time. Let's take a closer look at the Duraflex bushing, the heart of the Duraflex joint. The elastomer of the Duraflex bushing is fused to the inner convex sleeve. Therefore, there is no articulating surface for grit to get inside and cause damage like the ball and cups of a typical flex joint. The lubricant retaining grooves and outer surface act like a large surface bearing. It is important to use the Teflon impregnated synthetic grease provided by Metal Cloak. It is the only lubricant proven to work with the Duraflex bushing and not break down the elastomer. All petroleum-based lubricants will permanently damage the Duraflex bushing. Using your finger, simply fill the grooves on the surface with the Metal Cloak grease. To rebuild the joint, install the first retainer clip. There are two edges to the support washers, rounded and sharp. The round edge should always face towards a rubber Duraflex bushing. Hand feed the Duraflex bushing into the housing as far as you can. Use a rubber mallet to persuade the Duraflex bushing into place. Install the next support washer, making sure to put the rounded edge facing the Duraflex bushing. Insert the final retaining clip. It is important to check that the retainer clips are fully recessed into the grooves, and now you've assembled the Duraflex joint. So let's look at functionality of the control arms. Typical control arms have a ball and cup flex joint at one end and an OEM-style pressed bushing at the other. Metal Cloak control arms have the Duraflex joint at both ends. Functionally, the pressed OEM bushings are excellent in micromotion with no wear surfaces. Typical ball and cup flex joints rotate in micromotion but have exposed wear surfaces causing breakdown over time. The Duraflex joint is excellent in micromotion with no wear surfaces. In this animation, you can see that the micromotion of the Duraflex joint occurs entirely in the flex of the fused elastomer with no wear surfaces. But what about full movement or macro motion? The ball and cup flex joint has excellent macro rotation, but exposed wear surfaces still exist. Whereas the OEM style bushing has limited rotation and no wear surfaces. Metal Cloak's Duraflex joint has full macro rotation with a very large durable wear surface. The synthetic grease in the outside grooves installed earlier provide all the lubricant needed for long-term use of the joint. The animation shows that the Duraflex joint begins rotation with flex of the fused elastomer, then breaking free to act like a large surface bearing. Now let's take a look at lateral flex. Pressed OEM bushings have minimum lateral flex. They just don't want to go there. The typical ball and cup flex joint has an excellent lateral articulation, but must be forcefully realigned. Metal Cloak's Duraflex joint has the ultimate in lateral movement and, once again, simply no wear. The animation shows how the elastomer flexes in extreme articulation. During lateral movement, the pressed OEM bushing will center itself, but has minimum lateral flex. The ball and cup flex joint has full lateral movement, but can't self-center, which is why the ball and cup flex joint requires an OEM pressed bushing on one side of the control arm. With the Duraflex joint, you can now have excellent lateral articulation and fully self-centering control arms. But ultimately, articulation has a lot to do with twist, so how do the control arms do? The typical control arms using the OEM bushings and flex joint combination has limited twist. The medical hook arms with Duraflex joints at both ends truly get twisted. This diagram shows the difference. Over 28 more degrees of flex with a Duraflex joint. But how do these control arms act under real-world conditions? First, we twisted up a Jeep using our corner travel index platforms in order to show how well the typical control arm functions. Notice that the joints get all bound up in the clevis. Another set of typical control arms from a major manufacturer were previously installed on this rig. And once again, the joints get all bound up in the clevis. Then we tested our control arms. Since both ends of the control arms have the Duraflex joint and are self-centering, not only do you get full flex, but no binding on the clevises. Metal Cloak's Duraflex joint, bringing a new level of extreme articulation and comfortable ride to your on- and off-road experience.